Good morning, class. How are you all? I hope you all are fine, safe at home. Today we are going to start with geography. All right, isn't it new for you? All right, fine. Students, just I wanted to tell you, geography is our third book. Fine. First book, it was history. That was in the history we learned about all the past, all the ages, all the upcoming chapters will come upon the all the ashrams, all the Vedas, how the life becomes, and so many other things. In the civics, we had learned about the discrimination, diversity, and all. And further, we'll study about the government. Fine, how our government is, what way government is working right now. Then we'll know about the administration of urban, rural, and so on. That is all depends on the politics. Our third book is geography. That is, we have to know about the geography. In the next slide, I'll show you the cover page of our geography book. Now, students, why do we study geography? You know, geography is the study of a places and the relationship between people and the environment. Geographers explore both the physical properties of Earth's surface and the human societies spread across it. Geography seeks to understand where things are found, why they are there, and how they developed and change over time. This is what we learn in geography, all about the globe, political map, latitude, longitude is a familiar topic to you all. Fine, chapter 1 and this chapter, we are not skipping. I repeat, we are not skipping the chapter, but I'll be giving you the project of chapter number 1. Alright, that's what you have to do. Now, in the next slide, you will see the cover page of geography book. This is our front page or cover page of our textbook. Why we are starting with our new chapter, that is globe, latitude and longitude. I know that you all are aware about the chapter. So, it would be very easy to know about the chapter. Earth is not a sphere. It is a slightly flattened at the north and the south pole, and it's a bulge in the middle. All right. So I am here giving you the description about the globe. Globe, even it is a true model, or even you can say the miniature form of the Earth. This is what I have given you the introduction of globe. Here we proceed further. Equator. I know that you all are aware about the word equator. It means equal half. Alright. Imaginary line running on the globe divides it into two equal parts. One is northern hemisphere and other part, or the below of the globe, you can say it's known as a southern hemisphere. A very important reference point to locate places on the earth. Fine. Equator denotes as 0 degree also. Now we proceed towards to the latitude. All parallel circles from the equator up to the poles are called parallel of latitude. Why? Because all the lines which are running through the latitudes are parallel and all are measured in degrees. Always, I already said that equator represents the 0 degree latitude. 90 degree to the north latitude marks as the north pole, and 90 degrees south latitude marks as the south pole. So in short, even you can say 90 degree N, 90 degree S. Your N stands for north pole and S stands for south pole. All parallels north of the equator are called north latitude. All parallel south of the equator are called south latitude. As we move away from the equator, of course, the size of the parallel of latitude get decreases. Here we proceed the further. Beside the equator 0 degree, the north pole, that is 90 degree north, and the south pole, that is 90 degree south. They are four important parallel of latitude. This is what all the my dear students we have learned last year in Form 5. Tropic of Cancer, 23.5 degrees north in the northern hemisphere. Tropic of Capricorn, 23.5 degrees in the southern hemisphere. Arctic Circle at 66.5 degrees north of the equator. Antarctic Circle at the 66.5 degrees south of the equator. Now I'll be showing you the important diagram. My dear students, this diagram you have to draw in your study book or any book. Fine, at least twice, and you have to remember all the important latitude. Here we start. This is North Pole. This is a frigid zone. In the next upcoming slide, I'll teach you all three zones as well. Fine, this is Arctic Circle, 66.5 degrees N. This is compulsory to mention either N or S. So here, if you are so below the equator comes the S, and above the equator it comes the N. Then comes to the Arctic Circle, 66.5 degrees north, not temperate zone. Tropic of Cancer, 23.5 degrees north, torrid zone. Alright, equator, this both are torrid zone. I'll explain you in the next slide. Torrid zone is known as a hottest zone. Then comes to the Tropic of Capricorn, then south temperate zone. Then Antarctic Circle, 66.5 degrees, again the frigid zone and South Pole. With this diagram, I'll explain you the hit main three important zones. Fine, see, these are the frigid zone, no temperate zone, or even you can say the temperate zone and torrid zone. You can see this torrid zone is very near to the equator, so it is hot all the time. Fine. Then comes to the temperate zone. It is slightly far from the equator. So, temperate zone is neither very hot nor very cold. Then come to the frigid zone. Frigid zone is very far from the equator. So, this zone is frozen throughout the year. Alright, it is also called the white zone also. So, here I will explain you in detail. Fine. Torrid zone, it is also known as a high temperature. They are mainly three zones, heat zones of the earth. The midday sun is exactly overhead. Why it is very hot? Fine, because the midday sun is exactly overhead at least once a year on all the latitudes, that is between the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. Fine, and that is why this zone is called a torrid zone with a high temperature. Then comes to the temperate zone. It is very moderate. The midday sun never shines overhead on any latitude, that is between the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. We all know that the angle of the sun rays goes on decreasing towards the pole, and because of that, this area, whatever the area which falls under the temperate zone, is in moderate. Area bounded by the Tropic of Cancer and the Arctic Circle in the northern hemisphere, and the Tropic of Capricorn and the Antarctic Circle in the southern hemisphere. This is all known as a, you can say the north temperate zone, as well you can say that the south temperate zone. This is neither very hot nor very cold. Here the temperate zone is having a very moderate temperature. Then comes to the frigid zone, very cold zone. Area that is lying between the Arctic Circle and the North Pole in the northern hemisphere, and the Antarctic Circle and the South Pole in the southern hemisphere. Here they have just mentioned where does this frigid zone been located. It is because here the sun does not rise much over the horizon. Therefore, its rays are always slanting, and because the rays of the sun are not enough to make the warm this zone, that is why this area is having very less heat. Again, I repeat, torrid zone, it is very hot zone. Fine, with a high temperature. Then comes to the temperate zone, which is having a moderate temperature, that is neither very hot nor very cold. Then comes to the frigid zone, which this zone is very cold. Fine. I hope this heat zone of the earth is clear to you all. Next, I hope students that latitude is clear to you all. Now we proceed towards to the longitude. A given line of reference running from the North Pole to the South Pole, which gives into the east or west. Fine, here we have a two hemisphere, Eastern Hemisphere and Western Hemisphere. In the latitudes, we were having a two hemisphere. That was a Northern Hemisphere and Southern Hemisphere. The distance between them are measured in degree of longitudes. Each degree is further divided into minutes and then minutes into second. Suppose ke here 1 degree is to the, means here the minute has been count as a 4 degree. That what I'll explain you in detail. They are semicircle and the distance between them decreases steadily polewards until it becomes a zero at the pole. Well, where all the meridian meets, that is a North Pole and South Pole. We were having a equator in the latitude, here we having a prime meridian. All meridian are of equal length, but not all the latitude. So it was difficult to number the meridian. See, in the latitude, it was like all the lines were parallel. But exactly in the longitude, it's very difficult because it are having in equal length. But it's not, the lines are not a parallel. All right. Now, what is a prime meridian? Count begins from this meridian which passed through Greenwich, where the British Royal Observatory is located. Its value is 0 degree longitude, like what equator was having 0 degree equator. The same way here, 0 degree longitude is mentioned in the prime meridian. The prime meridian and 180 degree meridian divides the earth into two equal half. It is, however, interesting to note that 180 degree east and 180 degree west meridian are on the same line. Fine. So 180 degree E, even you can say 180 degree A west. This is very interesting to note that both are on the same line. Alright, in the next slide I will. Best means of measuring time is by the movement of the earth, the moons and the planets with the help of the movement of the earth. See, prior also I told you that sunrise, sunset, no. It is the earth which keep on rotating and revolving. Fine. On the, means towards the sun. It's not the sun that keeps on setting and rising. Prior, the people were not knowing. They were not having any sort of timings or any sort of watch. That is why with the help of those with the sun rising and setting, they'll come to know. Local time can be reckoned by the shadow cast by the sun, which is the shortest at noon and longest at sunrise and sunset. This is very common. You find at the noon our shadow of our own, fine, it becomes a short, and it becomes a long, whether it's a sunrise and sunset. When the prime meridian of Greenwich, as the sun is the highest point in the sky, all the places along this meridian will have a midday or noon. Even you can say a midday, or even you can say a noon. You know that government is providing midday meal. What is this midday meal? Means the you can say the government school, the children of the school, of the government school are getting a midday meal. It means 12 o'clock noon they are getting the meal. As the earth rotates from west to east, so places east of Greenwich will be ahead of Greenwich time. This is what I am explaining you in detail. Places west of Greenwich will be behind of Greenwich time. Say for example, today is Sunday, say for example, alright, and I am traveling towards to the eastern part. I repeat, I am traveling to the eastern part of the place, right? So I'll be having 1 day ahead, so I'll be reaching on Monday. But suppose ke I am starting from Sunday and I am traveling to the western part, say for example to the America, then I'll be reaching on Sunday itself. I repeat, western part, any of the place is been ahead, whereas in the eastern part we have one more day. Fine. So plus 1 minus 1, this is what you have to keep in your mind. The earth rotates 360 degree in about 24 hours. This is we all know. Fine. So here I'll explain you 15 degree per hour or 1 degree in 4 minutes. Because if you divide this 15 and into hours, fine. So you will get a 4. So your 1 degree is into the 4 minutes. Or you can divide this 24. So you will get a 15 degree. Alright, and this is what they converted into hours, hours into minutes. When it is a 12 noon at Greenwich, the time at 15 degree east of Greenwich will be 15 degree into 4. That what I explain you. So comes to 60 minute. That is 1 hour ahead of Greenwich time, which means 1 p.m. So in the eastern part, suppose ke 12 noon. We all know that we are observing the timings from the Greenwich Observatory, Royal Observatory, alright. So here we know that if it is a 12 noon, fine. So 1 hour will be ahead. So there will be 1 o'clock in the eastern part, whereas there will be 11 a.m. 11 o'clock morning in the western part. The time at 15 degree west of Greenwich, the time will be behind Greenwich time by 1 hour. That is, it will be 11 a.m. So here it will be p.m. There it will be a.m. Similarly, at 180 degree, whatever the places falls on the 180 degree, it will be midnight. I hope this is clear to you all. Fine. Just you have to keep in your mind that in the eastern parts, 1 day ahead. On the western part, 1 day minus. In the eastern part, 1 hour ahead than that of Greenwich. On the western part, 1 hour less compared to the Greenwich. See, this is a Greenwich. Fine, here plus, 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 all everywhere. Here minus, minus, minus. Fine, with the help of this, you have to do any sort of activity. Fine, which place is ahead. This page, I'll be sending you through PDF also of your chapter. In India, the longitude of 82 degree half, fine, eastern, your east ends for eastern, is treated as the standard meridian. So, our India is passing through, you can see from this map. Fine, our India is passing through 82 and half degree east. The local time at this meridian is taken as the standard time for the whole country. That is, they are talking about the Indian standard time. We all belongs to the India. India located east of Greenwich at 82 and half degree east. That is 5 hours and 30 minutes ahead of GMT. Your GMT means Greenwich Mean Time. Russia is having 11 standard time. USA is having 7. Whereas Canada is having a 6 standard time. The earth has been divided into 24 time zone of 1 hour each. And this each zone thus cover 15 degree of long. Thank you, class. I hope the chapter is clear. Then do, if you feel or if you find any difficulty, please do message me anytime. Students, hereby I'll be sending you the PDF of the chapter along with the questions that you have to solve all the questions in any of your book. Fine. And the next day I'll be sending you the solutions for the same. All right. Thank you. Stay home. Stay safe.